Hi and welcome. Batteries are today being used everywhere, especially the lithium-based type. There are a lot of myths, marketing hype and misinformation out there, and in many cases just overcomplicating things. A lithium battery and the way it works is not that complicated, and taking care of the battery, making sure you're not damaging it, is not that hard. One thing a lot of people seem to have a problem with is battery life on devices such as phones, tablets and laptops. I never had issues with my devices, so I thought I'd share with you what I do to keep my batteries lasting for as long as possible. I will also try to demonstrate how a lithium-ion polymer battery works and how it's constructed. I'm using a lithium polymer battery as an example here. Many of these devices use this type of battery, but not all of them. But the rules and principles apply to most of them. Let's take a closer look of how a LiPo cell is constructed and made. This is a simplified overview. Inside the cell, we will find stacked layers of thin metal sheets. One sheet is of aluminium, that is the positive cathode layer. It has a very thin layer of a lithium slurry, you could call it, coated to it. The other sheet is copper, that makes the negative anode side. To separate these layers, there is a thin layer of insulation film, also called the separator. These layers are then stacked on top of each other to form the battery cell. Everything is then covered by a pouch that is sealed in a vacuum. But before it's completely sealed, the electrolyte is injected to the battery, and then all the air is sucked out before the pouch is sealed. A so-called pouch lithium battery is sensitive to physical abuse, dents and scratches and bending. It doesn't take much to damage the very thin layers inside, leading to permanent damage, and that the battery may expand. Expanding of the cell is a clear sign of damage, and it should not be used anymore. There are several reasons to why a cell is expanding. This because of vaporization of the electrolyte, making the pouch expand, that mostly lead to a delamination of the cell. One should avoid high levels of state of charge. Not charge or discharge it to its max. This will damage the cell and could also result in expanding of the cell. In this state, the pouch could break and lead to a fire. So, never use a battery that you think is damaged in any way. Our phones, tablets and laptops makes sure the inside battery is not overcharged or over-discharged. And if the battery consists of several cells, the individual cells will be monitored and managed by a BMS system, a so-called battery management system. It can sometimes be hard to know the exact state of charge on our devices that it shows us. Some have an inbuilt buffer on the top and bottom of the part of the cell, so when it says 100%, it could in fact be 90 to 95%. This is common on electric cars. There is always a capacity buffer and a reserve that protects the battery. But on a device like a smartphone or a thin laptop, high energy density cells is being used and they are cycled hard, often to its maximum capacity. And I believe that they don't have as much buffer to offer. It's therefore in many cases up to the user to take extra care of the battery in the device. From experience, after I've tested and cycled many lithium cells and many of them being LiPo type, there is one thing that really degrade and damage the cells. That is deep discharge, to fully discharge the battery. Other factors are fast charging and leaving them fully charged for a longer period of time, and of course heat. Here are a few simple rules that I try to follow. When it's about 30% capacity left, it's time to charge. I never charge overnight, this because of safety reasons and that the battery won't be left on a high state of charge for a long period of time. When the battery is charged to 80 to 100%, I unplug it. I never fast charge. Even if a cell is designed to handle fast charging, that cell will last longer with a normal standard charge and degrade less over time. I try not to expose the battery to heat. For example, I won't leave my phone in the car during summer. I avoid most wireless chargers It's not as efficient, and those losses from the wireless chargers results in heat and potentially damage to the cell. It's normal that a battery will degrade over time, but what impacts the battery life the most is how it's being used and cycled. One thing that often comes up, that is misleading in my opinion, is the so-called calibration of the battery. You can't calibrate a lithium-ion battery. But depending on the device and how it works, its electronics and software method to measure that battery might need a calibration. And unfortunately, that sometimes means that you have to charge and discharge it fully. Another factor that also is discussed is long-term storage, that it has to be at a precise voltage or capacity level. The only important thing in this situation is that you leave the battery somewhere in between, not full, not empty. A general rule or standard is that when a lithium battery has 80% capacity left from degradation, it's considered as used. But one can of course use it beyond that. But from degradation and loss of capacity and higher internal resistance, the battery will not perform as well and will drop to a lower voltage during load. This could lead to that the device won't perform as good, it could run slower or won't run at all. At this point of time, the battery needs to be changed. So, this is my experience and in the way I treat and handle my batteries in these types of devices. Others may have other strategies or compromises. It's up to each to their own. But for me, these rules have served me well and given me long-lasting batteries and devices. So, all I can say now is thank you for watching.